I'm down here by my garage again, and over this next few days I'm going to try to get this driveway finished, graded, and get these hills sculpted the way I want, and get this ready to put some rock in here, because like I said, I didn't get to it before winter, and it was a mud pit out here, and now that the weather's nice and dry, I need to get it done. But first, what I got to do before I do that, here I'll show you first again. See, I got these dirt hills. My driveway, I started flattening it out with the bucket, and the hill over there. I got to sculpt all this so I can plant grass, put rock in, that kind of thing. But the first thing I have to do is get this finished mower off of here and get a box blade on it. So I just thought I'd show you real quick how this finished mower comes off of here. Basically, I'll just show you real quick and then we'll see if we can take it off. Sorry about the camera work here. It's pretty easy. It's got a bolt here. I've got it double nutted just so it doesn't slip out on me. And then once you get that loose, there's a little hook here that swings out that'll hold this shaft up in here while I back the tractor in up to the box blade. But anyway, once you get that bolt loose, and then all you gotta do is get these little pins out down here, and then I can slide this off of these pins, and then down here we've got this cover that pops up, and then let's see, I got this attached to the tripod. But if I zoom in here, maybe you can see, yeah, there's a little release pin right here if you look, and you just press that in, and that'll release it from the splines down there. And then I can slide that off of the shaft and get the shaft loose, okay? And that way I can get this thing completely off of here. So what I'm gonna do is just set this over here and get to work real quick. And then you guys will get to see it come off of here. Maybe you can kind of see what I'm up to while I'm on there. Let's see here. There we go. Sorry. All right, there we go. Sometimes it goes easier than others, depending on how long this has been on here. Just need a couple of big press brakes. Actually, man, that outside nut was on there pretty loose. Turn this baby off here. Actually, since it ain't been that long since I had it off, it's coming apart pretty easy. I think I'll take this camera off and just bring it with me, because then you can see more up close what's going on here. Okay, so basically you can see I'm removing these nuts here. I got the outside one off and the inside, and then usually you can just push that out and then our shaft's going to be loose. Now where this little hook that folds up in here, that comes into play, because you swing that out like so. And that way, if I can do this with one hand here, see, then that'll just sit in that, and that'll prop it up like that so that it's up out of the way when I get to drive onto the next one. And let's see. And then we'll reuse the same bolt to hook on the box blade here in a second. All right, now to remove this, you just flip this little cover up, you grab this, and it can be a little tight. You just push this pin in like so. Yeah, you just start yanking on it. Okay, since I had it greased up, it slipped off pretty good. So there's your spline shaft, okay? So now, you know, I got the shaft unhooked laying on the ground. And then the next thing we gotta deal with is these little babies right here. Now these, you just pull these little pins out, and sometimes they'll fight you a little bit. And you know, you can use a tool if you have to. Anyway, I'll lay the pin over there. Once you pull that pin, you just get this out. Then we'll go ahead and do both sides. Okay. Again, you just gotta get this off of here. You know, usually if it's big enough, you can get your finger in there like so. Give it a good pull. Okay, got that out. Lay them up where I know where they're at. Pull this T-bolt out. Now, you see, now these might be a little tight on there. And with this thing being up snug to the tractor, it takes a little fiddling sometimes. But now, here's the important part on this tractor. If you kick down on this with your foot like so, this actually, it actually releases these end pieces. And they can can see that. See how it flexed out? And now it gives me the extra length I need to roll that off of there, okay? And you do the same thing over here. You just go up here, and right there, you just take your foot, slam it down like so. That, you know, that'll loosen that up, and that allows you to drag this end out, okay? Now, sometimes, if it fights me a little, I'll start the tractor up, drive it up to give me a little more play in this thing. But, let's see. This is hard to do one-handed. Jeez. Okay. Anyway. All right. Now, this thing's heavy, so usually you just got to do a little bit of working back and forth. Anyway, I've almost got this pin out, so all I got to do is give this a little quick tug, and it'll come off of here. Let me see. Man, this is hard. Camera, sorry, I'm gonna set it down for a second. Okay. Now, you can see that this side's totally out, separated. Now, generally speaking, I'll usually have the tractor fired up, but it'd be too loud for you, so I left it off. And then, because once I get that free, I can lift up the 3-point. And it'll get it up out of the way where I can swivel this thing around a little bit. But anyway, now all I gotta do basically is shove this side out. Which all you gotta do is get this released so that it can move around a little bit. And then it just takes a little bit of shoving on here. You can see it's starting to come off already. Hey, here's where editing would come in handy, huh? Anyhow, I need to lower that arm down so that I can get it to come out smooth over there. But anyhow, you can see how that comes apart here. Back here. Let's see. Man, this is a long video for just showing how to do that. But anyway, you can see, you know, the shaft is unhooked, shield's up. This is hanging up on its hook, so it's out of the way. And then this, I've already got the pin loose, and then all I gotta do is put this camera down and I'll pull that other pin loose, and then we'll be totally disconnected, okay? And then all I gotta do, back it in there to the box blade and hook it all up. And what I'm gonna do is come back and show you another video of how to hook it up to the box blade, okay? so anyway, it's a little harder than I thought with one hand, but anyway. But I just thought I'd give you an idea how that all hooks up, and I'll come back and show you the box blade here in a little bit. So I'll see you. Bye.